having. This is videos related to bilingual language tests, and this is video number 6, where I'm going to give you terminology related to another 4 areas: skin, muscles, neuro, and hepatic. Okay, this is about the blood, the fourth one, about have you had anemia. Okay, so I will give you this terminology that you need to know, because if you have a doctor-patient scenario in medical bilingual terminology, or so-called L4 or STAT-L4-HT, which is medical interpreter language proficiency level 4, you need to know those terminologies, and I hope to be useful for you. I've been studying them myself, and this helped me to pass my test in different languages. So if I pass it, you can do it too. If I did it in 5 languages, you can do it in any language you want. Okay, the first one is skin. Skin cancer, or skin cancer. Rush, itching, unhealed sores or wounds. This is classical, guys. Unhealed sores or wounds, change of a mole, nail deformation or decoloration. Now we're gonna give you some. Number 2, it's about muscles. Joint or muscle pain, they go together, muscle and joints. I don't know why. Okay, so it's a joint pain, stiffness, and always just come with stiffness in the hands or in the shoulders, or stiffness in your feet. Then numbness, they love this one on the test. Numbness, lump pain. This one I didn't pass on the test, I know for sure, because I didn't know the lump, I think, in the target language, because lump is a very particular word. So lump pain, which means like body part pain, which include hands and foot. Bone pain, a back pain. It could be arthritis, knee, hip, joint. So, have you had artificial knee, hip, or joint? Lump weakness, okay, just remember this particular, and they like to put at least 3 particular words in the test. Difficulty to walk, tingling or numbness. If there is no tingling, there will be numbness, so just remember that. Falls, heavy fallen, joint pain, osteoporosis or arthritis. This is going to the bones, not exactly about the muscles. Also here, probably I didn't include it in my notes, there could be a muscle cramp, muscle ache, muscle problem, muscle pains. But honestly, working as a medical interpreter, there is less common problems with functioning muscles, there is more problem with the bones. Now we have some, I call them neuro, but they are not exactly neuro, they're just some kind of a strange symptoms here, with not only with the head, but let's start. Migraine, headache, vertigo, thyroid problems, do you have a temperature problem? Have you ever had paralyzed arm, legs, face? Is your part of your left side normally, if the person have a stroke or ictus, arm, legs, face don't move correctly? Speech difficulties and seizures. And then the I am not sure how to pronounce this. I think it's related to hepatic system, hemoglobin. Anyway, it's related to the blood disorders. You probably know better the word than me, and if you see my handwriting, you probably will have a hard time to read it as I do. Anemia, low platelet count. So this is the same thing, but the low platelet count, they give it on the lab results. When they say, okay, you have a low platelet count, this is anemia. Bleeding disorder, easily bruising. This is something particular they like to give on the chest. Easily bruising, leukemia or lymphoma. Leukemia or lymphoma. And that was all my terminology in this video number 6. Thank you for being here, liking, sharing, and subscribing. Have a great day. Bye-bye.